Hey friend, welcome to the Self-Care Isn't Selfish podcast. I'm your host, Emily Nichols. As a Whole30 certified coach, wife, busy working boy mom, and your self-care guru, I'm here to help you start putting yourself first without the guilt. Each week you'll hear motivating and practical tips on how you can create a habit of self-care through interviews with my amazing guests or quick solo episodes with me. After each episode, you'll walk away with an action plan and feel empowered to implement what you have learned into your life. So grab a cup of coffee, glass of wine, or your favorite sparkling water, and let's do this. You're listening to episode 5 of the Self-Care Isn't Selfish podcast. This week's self-care quickie tip is all about meditation. Yep, meditation. We are getting a little woo-hoo this week, but I really truly believe in the power of meditation or prayer, however you'd like to see it, and how it's been transformative in my life. So I'm going to share a little bit with you today about the benefits of meditation and some action steps for you for how you can start utilizing meditation and part of your self-care routine today. So let's talk about just a couple of the benefits of meditation. So there's actually been some studies that have shown that meditation can help reduce your cortisol levels. Now that is your stress hormone. So when you're really, really stressed or anxious, your cortisol levels are high. Meditating a few minutes a day can help lower those cortisol levels, thus reducing your stress and anxiety. Another physical benefit of meditation is lowering your blood pressure. Kind of going back to that lower cortisol as well. You're a little bit more chill, not so stressed out. So thus your blood pressure will start to go down, and that in turn helps you decrease your chances for cardiovascular disease. Another benefit of meditation that I think is very worthy of noting is how it can lengthen your attention span. I know for me, I got a million different things running through my head, so being able to lengthen my attention span helps me focus better at work, be more present with my kids, and there's also been some studies that it may reduce age-related memory loss. And I know for me, just personally speaking, I feel like I have become more self-aware of myself through meditation. So just sitting in silence for 5 minutes a day, whether it be guided or not, I feel like I get a lot of messages from God or the universe at that time, and I'm able to tap into what I'm really thinking, whether it be thoughts about myself, self-limiting beliefs. I learn how to knock those away and replace them with self-love and self-talk instead, and that really just puts a positive spin on my day. Hey gang, jumping in real quick to remind you that all of my self-care quickie tip episodes are brought to you by my online Whole30 courses. As I've mentioned numerous times, Whole30 helped change me from the inside out, and I now help my clients eat, move, and love themselves to help them find their own version of self-care, food freedom, and to put themselves first without feeling the guilt. So head on over to my website, it's just emily-nichols.com, and check out all of my Whole30 courses. If you weren't able to get into one of my most recent Whole30 groups, if the deadline has already passed, no worries. I am always taking on Whole30 private clients if you'd like to get coached one-on-one, or also if you're just looking for a little bit of virtual accountability, some little tough love and cheerleading from me, then sign up for my Whole30 Anytime course. These are courses you can do anytime throughout the year when you're ready to give Whole30 a try. Just a reminder, it's emily-nichols.com, or follow along on Instagram at emilynichols22 so you can get all the updates on what's happening with my Whole30 courses. And just because I love my podcast listeners, once you head to the site and purchase your course, I have a special discount code for you. Just enter at checkout SELFLOVE. That's just SELFLOVE, SELFLOVE, all one word, all capitals, to receive a discount. So can't wait to see you inside the course and help you change from the inside out through Whole30. So let me tell you how I meditate. I use the app Headspace to guide me through a meditation. Because like I said, I'm like a squirrel sometimes. I see so many different things. I get distracted real easy. So I need an app to help me begin my meditation. And I use Headspace. Calm is another one you can try out as well. But usually I meditate for 5 minutes at a time. I try to do it every single morning. Now, I get up at 4:35 some mornings to go work out. And as much as I would like to, get up 5 minutes earlier and meditate, sometimes that doesn't happen. So usually after my workout, I like to meditate then, which is something I learned from T-Mac Fitness. I'll link him in the show notes as well. He was someone we got to interact with at the Whole30 Coach Summit, and there was just great benefits to meditating after you work out. But I'll usually do it on my couch. Sometimes I'll even do it in my car before I go inside because my oldest son gets up early. So he's up sometimes getting ready for middle school in the morning. And I'd rather sit in my car and get my meditation done before I go in and help him finish getting ready for the day. I prefer to do it in the morning. If I can't get it in the morning, I will do it at any point throughout the day. Another idea you can use other than like the Headspace or Calm app is to put some reminders or notifications on your phone or on your calendar. I've done this before with my Apple Watch. You know, sometimes it will vibrate and tell you it's time to meditate. And no matter what I'm doing, even if I'm driving, I'll say a little prayer or say a little mantra in my head. And it really does help calm me down, really focus back in, and helps me take on whatever's coming my way in that next minute, half hour, or hour. So don't feel like you have to have it at a certain time of day. It can also be broken up into different chunks of the day. I think prayer and meditation throughout the day is a great way, like I said earlier, to help reduce your stress and clear your mind for the day. I want to leave you today knowing that you need to give yourself grace if you're going to start trying to meditate. It's hard. You have to make it a habit and make it something scheduled on your calendar, or like I said, use something like an app or notifications on your phone to help you do it every single day. And it's going to take some time. You may feel silly at first the first time you do it, or you may be like, this is really woo-woo. But trust me, it's transformational. And over time, as it becomes more of a habit, you're going to have God and the universe speaking to you a lot more because you're going to be listening. Okay. That's the biggest thing. You're going to be listening versus just rushing through your life. So take the time for you today. Incorporate meditation into your self-care routine, whether it be a few minutes here or 5 minutes or 10 minutes or a half an hour, whatever works for you, but give it time. And I want to know the benefits that you see as well. So don't forget to take a snapshot of you or a screenshot sharing, listening to today's episode, and tag me at EmilyNichols22 or at Self-Care Isn't Selfish Podcast. And I'd love it if you leave me a rating or review today if you love today's episode. So until next week, guys, remember, self-care isn't selfish. Bye.